Good afternoon, viewers. Welcome to the Round 14 Chaos BRL Premier Grade Clash. We're at home today with the West Panthers versus the Normanby Hounds. Joining me today, we have Ben Newton on the cans as well, and putting on some expert commentary there. We're looking at the ladder there today. You see the West Panthers undefeated at this stage, playing 12 wins. The top five, we have the Bulldogs, the Bears, the Pride and the Diehards, Rennie, at the top five, but the Roosters on equal points with them. We see today the clash between West, who are on top, versus the Hounds, who are sitting in eighth place there with only the four wins. Also in the four, we have Bulimba playing against the bottom place Magpies. So they're hoping for a win there to try to keep in touch with the top place Panthers. In third and fourth, the Pine Rivers and Bean Lee are playing off today, so should be a good game out there between those boys. And of course, Valley's playing Brighton. For the West Magpie, West Panthers, Van Claveren at fullback. On the wings, we have Taki Taki and Wakalivu, who is sitting on second place of the leading try scorers. In the centres, Tuagani and Tuatali. In the halves, we have Britton Snowden and Kyle Foxwell. In the props, Tuafoe and Boyton, who's had a cracking season so far. Toby Westcott in at hooker there. Second rowers, we have Callahan and Ballinger. Dempsey is locking out the scrum. On the bench, we have Velikot, Wallace, Fonogaloa and Vali. So, and over for our Normanby Hounds, Ben.
At fullback, we got Downing Brown. The wings are Tamua and Dixon. The centres are Hallinan and O'Donoghue. In the halves, we got Hemopo and Campbell. The props are Perry and Justin Fye. And the hooker is Augustino Molo. The back row, we got Samuel McNulty and Forster as the lock. On the bench is Clifton, Samu, Finch and Hunter.
And both teams coming off a win from last week. So the West boys played against the Brighton Roosters and had a good win, 46-10. Then and also the Normanby Hounds playing against Beenleigh Pride, who were sitting in the top four at the moment, sitting fourth. They had a really good win, 24-12 against them. So some great players to watch here, Ben. So who you got your eye on here today?
I've just found out today that the lock for the Hounds has recently played for Poland in the Emerging Nations tournament. So it'll be good to see him run around, an international player. And the halfback as well, Campbell, actually did the pre-season with the Jets, actually in the Intra Super Cup. So it'd be good to see him run around and maybe stir an upset.
Well, the West Panthers certainly don't want that to happen, because they've had some strong performances there. The halves leading the way with Britton Snowden and Kyle Foxwell leading the troops around the track. And all the games we've seen this year from Panthers have been mistake-free. They've been rucking through the middle, doing all the hard yards and capitalising on any mistakes that the opposition have been making, which have been has been costly at crucial times for the opposition, but West's ready to pounce there. So I know that Craig and Ty Ingebrigtsen are the coaches here for the Panthers, and they've got the boys well and truly charged. I know that, I don't know what your take on it is, you know, people start talking about, you know, the win that or the loss that they've got to have across the season. I know that the coaches certainly don't come into that, you know, they're trying to win every game, but is that something that you'd think is, you know, a loss throughout the rounds creates a bit more hunger for the teams moving forward?
Yeah, it definitely can just wake them up a bit and get rid of that complacency. It's very easy to get complacent, so obviously the coaches don't want that, but I think the Hounds might be ready to pounce today and cause an upset.
I love it there, Betty. So we see the games of the rounds there. Hounds are playing the Magpies. So the Hounds are playing the Panthers today. But knowing that the Roosters are just outside that six today, and they've got their eyes on that top six, so hoping that they can get a win catch up to those diehards and also the Pride there. So look, it's been a tight competition. West have been the Penrith of the NRL. They've been the leaders in the competition. Look forward to some hard hits earlier. No one likes to lose at their home ground, but they like to put on the strong performance for all to see. So looking forward to this clash here today. And I know we won't quite see it yet, but the home ground, the West Panthers, leading us onto the field here today. Looking forward to it. And the Panthers, their fullback is certainly exciting. Fullback that comes, Kyle Van Claveren, comes through the middle an awful lot, backs up those forwards who like to offload close to the line. Also, I expect to see plenty of work from Josh Boyton, who's one of the leading props in the competition. Certainly damaging, one of the ones you'll see get fast to his feet. One of the larger props in the game. So I look forward to his impact as well. But as always, Simon Britton Snowden and Kyle Foxwell leading around the field as we go. So waiting now for the Normanby Hounds to make their way onto the field. Just getting their last minute instructions there from Aliana Mara, the coach. So lovely sunny day here out at West Michie, the home of, often hear it, the home of where Fatty Vorden used to play. And here they come onto the field, getting ready for the kickoff here. Before they do that kickoff, Ben, thoughts of State of Origin Wednesday night?
Oh, man, it was bloody great, wasn't it? Hey?
Spoken by a true Queenslander there, so sorry to all our New South Wales viewers, but yeah, great performance and one of the better games of Origin in recent memory anyway, so especially because Queensland won as well. All right, ready to kick off here?
Looks a fast track, Brendan. I reckon we could have an entertaining game, mate.
Yeah, well, hopefully that's the case. West certainly had in the second grade, had a great win over the, not sure the final score, it was a bit of a cricket score in the end, but a bit of a blowout, so they're looking to back-to-back here. So as West go to kick off. Seeing them rucking out here, good strong ruck. Three in the tackle to start with, we can see just outside on the 12 metre line. Simple rucks up the middle. Toby Westcott underneath there, slowing the play down a bit as well. As we saw, I think that was Faye. Hard to see these numbers on the back here, Ben. The Normanby. See Milo handing off there. Just simple one out rucks here at this stage. Again, we see Faye taking his second ruck. A good offload there. Following it through, just a bit of lazy play there, but I think that's Downing Brown who has the ball. And Brad Campbell just getting them out of town here. Van Claveren taking the ball and handing off to Takitaki, running it infield here, setting up good strong carry back there. Just outside the 20, setting up the first play. Van Claveren, a dummy half there, taking a scoot. Selling it here. We see Britton Snowden getting his players, marshalling his players in there. Another ruck up there from Wakalivu. Takes it up to the 40 metre line. Tufeo looking to get this ball. All locked up here there. And looking to get the ball out of here. Kicking on the 50. Short stabbing kick into the bottom corner. Dixon taking the ball here and rucking it out. Great chase there.
It's two good sets to start, mate. I think West Panthers are gaining the territory battle early here. Got them locked down on their 20 at the moment.
Good offload there, and as every good fullback does, in Downing Brown backing up through the middle. Lightweight there, though, isn't he?
Yeah, he might be nippy around the ruck there.
Yeah, well, great offload there. Going down, we see, is it Foe? No, sorry, it's McNulty. And a bit of a high shot there. But a promising play there from the Hounds down that right hand.
Yeah, that's a few offloads now they've looked for. I think they're trying to play it nice and quick and get down the other end of the field. Mara's got to be happy for the start.
Just watching the replay here. Just didn't quite get it there, but it, high shot. We're just punching it out, and they're setting up 20 metres out. O'Donoghue with the tap. Taking it down there, nice settler. It's Forster. Forster changing guard. Back in there, just setting up the play. Just 2 metres out. Molo, crash over play here from Faye. Held up just short. A little knock on there, trying to ground the ball perhaps a bit more exuberant than what he wanted to do. Watching the replay here.
Going for the crash ball. Great effort from the 12 there. Great strength from Ballinger to hold him up and force a mistake in there. A chance gone begging for the Hounds.
Certainly a appeal there from Homopo, the six. For the Hounds, thinking there's a bit of a strip there, but obviously the ref right in there saw clearly it was just a loss in the play of the ball, in the trying to ground it. And he had good in-out ball. Dicing with that sideline there. Taki Taki. Foxwell, who sets up another runner through the middle. Foxwell. Just mistake-free play here, getting out of their own half. On to Boyden. Working hard in those post-contact meters. Finds, gets rolled on his back. Looking to get out of town here. Slipping over as he kicked the ball. Or through the legs, bit of tunnel ball. Great pick up here from Downing Brown. Cleaning up. Grapple tackle there from Tori Tali.
Great set defensively from the Hounds, kicking them from the 30 basically, and they're already in the attacking half. They're looking for an attacking kick at the end of this set, I think.
Good tackle there from Dempsey, putting him on his back. Faye going again, setting a strong start to this half. Molo. Oh, slipping there, I think that's Forster. Again, just slipping. The Polish international.
That's correct.
Samuel rolled onto his back, last tackle. Coming to the left-hand side. Fullback running it through. Downing Brown through, pass off to his winger. And I think that is Tamua. Is it? Or
Dixon, I think. No?
Dixon. Dixon crossing over in the corner, bringing around a little bit further for his kicker. Downing Brown, little show and go, getting outside his centre. Partner drawing the winger and Dixon scoring in the corner. Let's see it here.
Yeah, Downing Brown, we said he was a lightweight, but he looks quick on his feet here on the replay. Gets the ball, just skips on the outside, beats his man, and cut out ball. I think that's Dixon there who takes it round, and the Hounds off to a flyer.
I think it's actually Hallinan, the try scorer there.
It is too.
So. Yeah. So, because Dixon was just backing
missed
him
out
up as well. So, well, great start there to the Hounds. And as you said earlier, this is the chance, you know, that they'll for an upset here. So, great bit of work there from Downing Brown, the show and go. He was listed originally during the week to start off the bench. So, but with Smith out for this round, he comes into the fullback position. Has had a great start to the game, actually, and has been, although, yeah, light on his feet, he's cleaned up at the back pretty well, but he's certainly made plenty of use of his speed out wide there, creating the overlap, getting round the centre for Wes, and getting in the back line, in the background, drawing Van Claveren, passing on to Helena for a great first try there for the Hounds. Seeing now, is it Homopo trying to kick from out wide? It's in the NRL, you think these days now every try is worth 6 points with the accuracy of some of these goal kickers. So we know that as the train goes past, we'll do it. The home ground advantage, they try to get everything happening here. But yeah, not so much in this grade as at 6 points every try. But
no, it'd be a valuable 2 points though.
Makes good contact, but just drags it to the left there. So the score remains at 4-0 to Normanby Hounds.
Coach Mara has to be happy with this start, Brennan. Very, very physical and fast, and looking for those offloads.
Well, whenever you come to a home ground advantage, and it's really a must-win game for them, they've got to start like they have. And it looks like they've done well to begin with. But can they continue it is what they'll be asking now. So Milo looking to get his big fellas, get us out of here. So I think that one was Perry. On to Forster. Good meters out there, the Polish international.
He's been good, hasn't he?
He has been good, actually. Good post-meter runs there as well. Nolte. Milo's steering them well around well from half, dummy half as well. Kick here from Campbell. Good up and under. Ben Claren underneath. Takes it comfortably. Hands off. Spreads it wide. That's the second time he's spread wide so far.
Great set for the Hounds after points to go 90 metres, and they got the Panthers back in, deep in their own half then.
And Claren distributes from dummy half. Does it quite a bit, actually. Gets in there and gets action from the dummy half. So straight out here to Ballinger. Good strong run there. And he's clear. Is he free to go? He must have called hell there, the ref. Playing on a nice early kick for the corner here. Good weight on that. Chasing it by... Or exactly what he wanted to do, get out of town there. Tacky Tacky making a valuable tackle.
Great keep, a great return from Downing Brown, showing his fast feet again.
Good tackle here from Boyden and Ballinger as well. Nice and strong in defence there, but how good is Downing Brown coming out of danger there? Very elusive on that, on those, on the feet on his try line there.
Winger Dixon definitely helped him out a bit with running the boys off the ball there. But yeah, he's showing all his skills out the back there.
Yep. Good strong run. He's nearly through. Poked his nose through again there. That was fire. He's had a strong start. Milo from dummy half looking for good 15 metre run there. Mark is a bit lazy then. So we have Downing Brown looking for a kick here. And up and under again from Campbell. Vol Claveren underneath it. Takes it comfortably. Looking for his winger again. Might have to take this one up himself. Trying to get outside his men. Good defence there from the Hounds, and they turn him. They work him in the tackle.
Great set again from the Hounds to put up an attacking kick. Campbell's hit a nice couple of floaters so far.
Tacky Tacky doing a lot of work out from his own line as well. So, and this is a two out. Two and guy. Yep. Foxwell. To Dempsey. Hounds are certainly doing well, turning him in the tackle. Tuafeo, good meters there, straight up the middle. Finds his feet, last tackle. Setting up Britton Snowden, no, it's gone Foxwell's way. Using the hands to Arnagy and caught on the last tackle there. Opportunity, they're trying to outstrip him there, I think Ben just out wide there. And trying to put Tucky Tucky into a space.
Yeah, they looked up and saw something on the short side. Didn't work out for him. Great defence from the Hounds. They've really aimed up at the start here.
This is Dixon now. He's limited opportunity, but he's cleared the markers there and got some good range out wide. So now onto O'Donoghue and getting him out inside the 10 metres. So a relieving penalty there for the Normanby Hounds.
Just offside there, the Panthers. A bit too eager to keep him down here.
There's a Campbell now looking for some metres. A really excellent kick.
It's a great kick.
He's found touch there on the 30-metre line.
Hounds on the charge again.
Perfect opportunity here. Two balls. Hang on there, boys. Two balls on the field. O'Donoghue here taking a tap. McNulty there centering the field, centering the play. Molo. Forster. Zeb Samuel. And losing the ball in close there. Claiming his little strip there, but no, not the ref has said no. He's loose carry there. And good defence has seen turnover. Just watching it here again. He lost it in the tackle.
Yeah.
Loose carry. Well, the good thing, Downing Brown was there again, just in case. Got the offload, but then he was there cleaning it up. But yeah, certainly a valuable turnover there for the Panthers, who are trailing at the moment 4-0.
Yeah, you get the feeling the Hounds need to make the most of their opportunities. Once the Panthers get down, they haven't been in a good ball yet. Bit of a break here.
Some excellent stepping out there. I think that was
Tuatali,
yes. A bit of slowing the play of the ball down. Six to go. He's cool. Takitaki. Oh, sorry. No, that's Wakalevu. Britton Snowden looking bored in the middle. Handing off to Tufeo. Slowing the play of the ball down really well here, the Hounds. Sitting on the 40-metre line. That's Dempsey taking it straight up, finding his feet. Westcott, good kick through it. Oh, he's elusive again there, Downing Brown. Just evading the tackle there of Boyden. Setting up again. Shooting down the wing side. Helen. Oh, sorry, that's not Helen, and that's O'Donoghue. Just one out running there just to get out to the, and they're sitting at the 35-metre line. Molo. Looking for a clearing kick here for Kemp. Getting over the head of the winger. Is it too deep? It's got some good run on there. It has. Unfortunately, a seven tackle set here. Problem is they can't take that tap because at the moment Tuafeo is still just crossing the 40-metre line now after copping a little bit of a knock, taking his time to get back, so hence the delay. Tap there from Wakalevu. Good strong contact there. That was O'Donoghue taking that tackle there, making that tackle. Spreading it wide, spreading it left, turning his body there. Just couldn't offload. They did take on the third tackle, didn't think it was a good opportunity there, so Britt Snowden. Right in the middle of the field here. Playing there, Westcott. Early kick there from Britt Snowden. Nice high field, good pressure coming through. Good take again. And elusive once again. Beats the first tackle. How often, Ben?
Yeah, he's always making 5-10 metres, even when the chases are right there, Brennan. He is elusive.
Now, I think you'll find that one's Tamua making his way over there once again. I mean, Forster rucking up there, making a solid 13 metres. He's been very strong so far. That's Campbell onto Fayo. He's had a strong start to this half. Campbell leading away again. Great offload there to Samuel. Last tackle, spinning it left. Campbell, short kick, found the feet though of the defender. There, I think you'll find that was, I think it was actually the halfback in Foxwell. Found it there and stopped the play, watching the replay here.
Yeah, kicked it in his leg, down in Brown again, looking dangerous. Everything looks like it's gonna happen around him for the Hounds.
And we rejoin them here, and there's been a turnover. McNulty taking the ball, intercepting the ball after that turnover and setting up play with six to go. on the 35 metre line. The hounds in attacking position here. Perry taking the ball up the middle for a nice settler. Forster setting it up 10 metres out. In perfect position here. Left or right? Milo handing it on again. I think that's Perry, that one. Campbell onto, I think that's a new player that came on before. And a strip one-on-one. Great work there from Kyle Van Claveren. So perfect timing there. So, and using the ball. Out wide. Oh, cut out pass there, missing Takitaki. But he's able to clean up. Ruck it straight back in the centre and set up the play again for West Panthers. So it didn't cost him too much there at least.
No, the Hounds missed another opportunity. You just hope for their sake it doesn't cost them too much. That's three or four times they've turned it over.
Wakaluvi come in here trying for another strip there, Milo. So the one-on-one, but Wakaluvi doing some metres for the forwards. Good metres there. I think that's Dempsey coming through the guts. Holding him down. Boyd, strong again as always. Last tackle on the 30. Looking for an attacking kick, or they run it this time. Britton Snowden, high bomb. Out to the winger, there's contesting. Knock back from West, and a little knock on there. Claiming it came off his legs, but that's not how the referee saw that one. Turnover there, but the Hounds will have to come out of their bottom corner. Seeing the bomb here.
Yeah, knock back from the Panthers winger, but it looks like the centre's just knocked it on and might have had a look at the try line.
Hounds rucking out here now, so these are hard metres as well. I think we'll find that one's Helen and I on that side of the field. Rucking out Dixon, so the outside backs are doing the work here for the forwards, which is well called for.
Yeah, Ford's been busy, that's well needed.
Fayo getting a much needed rest after a bit of an offload, even though he was on the ground there. Fayo, a great first 20 minutes, he's off. Good offload here, so second phase play here. That's Hellenan. Last tackle. Campbell once again going aerial. Van Claveren underneath. Great take over his head.
Spiral kick that time from Campbell. He's hit him well from the midfield bomb.
He's been controlling the game pretty well from the centre of the field there. So another offload there. And we'll see Funalagoa. Langloa, the replacement, he's come on here. Foxwell. To engage. Foxwell. Oh, great offload there. That's from Wallace. Unbelievable. Looking at a strip there. Yes. Two men in the tackle. Nice strip there. Or a penalty. The first we're seeing here on the replay.
Great offload. Westcott had his eyes up there. And looks like a strip.
Yeah, two in the tackle. So a bit of a timeout here for the referee. The injured player, I think we're finding there, is it?
I think it's our man Forster.
Is it? He's down. Down engine, this is if you have a look at the wide shot there, you'll see plenty of the Normanby Hounds that are sucking it in as well. So timely injury break, let's say. So, and we see that they're regrouping themselves. Brad Campbell, they're coming over, checking on his troop. He's had a strong start to the game, the halfback here for Normanby, hasn't he?
He has, he's been really good. His control, he's really kicked well. But that penalty has given the Panthers their first opportunity of the game.
And you notice them in the ruck there. You see the two of the tackle there. One just dropped off just a bit too late. This is the opportunity. They're not going for goal. They're taking the tap and going straight through the middle with Boyton. This is the opportunity. They haven't had much ball down this half. Foxworth. That's Tuatali, takes a tackle. Inside the 10 metres now, Wakalivu, darting from dummy half forward. And knock out, calling knock on there from the Hounds. Must have got a ball in there, but that was lucky there because Wakalivu trying to scoot out from dummy half, just seeing the replay.
Yeah, there it is. The four, Hallinan tried to get the ball back for the Hounds there, but just spilled his lollies.
So he got a little touch there, which puts the Panthers in perfect position here, attacking position, left or right. They're playing the extra man here on the left in the attack, so they've got four standing on the left and only the three defenders. So they haven't numbered off too well here, although they've come this to the right side. Ben Claveren on, going around the outside, and has he got there? He's grounded it. The ref seems happy with that, just getting outside his man. I think that's O'Donoghue. He just got outside. He looked to show and go, and eventually got past his man, playing the ball down the corner. Both the touch judge and the referee were happy. It's a clean try, but just what they needed at this time.
Yeah, set play from the scrum here with the half and the extra man from the other side coming around to create the overlap. Van Claveren gets the ball early, and he just beats his man there and gets around him. They actually slid quite well there, the Hounds. I think the Hounds will be a bit disappointed after they've thrown away a few opportunities, Brendan, and then the first time the Panthers are down here, they've let them in.
Unfortunately, our camera angle's blocked there, but that's just, we saw it. He got it in with about 30 centimetres to spare there, so a much-needed try there from West Panthers, Kyle Van Claveren. There's you're right there, Ben, that the Hounds have been really good and strong in defence early, and the two on the tackle, the strip there, the penalty that set them up, and then when the six again came, or the knock on came when they touched it in flight. Unfortunate, you know, they've been doing so well in defence, but I think the relentless pressure there from the Panthers. We're watching Kyle go around the outside again and just beating his man O'Donoghue on the outside there. Dixon staying well on his winger. The kick attempted conversion, missing to the left. Scores stay level now at 4-4.
Yeah, 25 minutes in. I think it's probably fair to say the Hounds are dominated. The scoreboard probably doesn't reflect the game, but credit to the Panthers to keep knocking back the Hounds and score a try on their first opportunity. So Coach Amara here will be hoping for a strong defensive set from the Hounds to keep them down this end.
This round 14 clash sponsored by Chaos Gear. Shop Chaos for all your four-wheel drive and camping gear, your leading Australian outdoor store. Kicking off here, Campbell. Just wobbling kick there, so Ben Claveren handing off to Wakalivu. Getting out to the 20, which is always the goal of the attacking team. Wanting to get metres through the middle now. I think we'll find that's Wallace again, who's had a strong game since he's come on here. Taking it on the second tackle, just short of the halfway, and they're going over now into the Hounds half. And more. And some. So good, strong run there. Into the 35. Out, so that's a good 20 metre run there. Dempsey or Wallace. Kick to the corner, on the ground, find the ground, and oh! Some quality defence there, that's Tamura. Through the middle here, Tamura, is he going to go all the way? Ben Claveren coming across in defence. He's taking him on, he's got him on the halfway line there.
So that was a great set from the Panthers there, Brendan, but great return from Tamua. Puts the pressure right back on the Panthers.
And they spread it straight away. Dixon got the ball out wide here. Is he going to take them on? Takitaki got him in defence there. That's Samuel up the middle. He's had a strong half as well. That's Zeb Samuel. Campbell. Dummy. That's McNulty out wide there. Campbell. Forster. Forster selling in the middle now. Lost ball there. One on one strip. Great turnover. That's the second one they've done down here, West Panthers. Calls for a forward pass. Taki Taki taking it up. The wingers have done a lot of work for them, giving the likes of Boyton here a rest as well, so that the outside backs have been strong for both teams here. Looking for an early kick, kicking on the 40. Looking for 40-20 here, bounce. I'll tell you what, they were very lucky there. Just hasn't gone dead, perfect weight there. Good chase here.
Jeez, that's a great kick.
Wasn't it just? I think he was aiming for a 40-20, but just got a right hand, bit of an off spinner there.
Yeah, unlucky not to get it, but still a pretty good result, coming off your own dead ball long.
Well, certainly a good result, and that's Hallahan getting valuable meters out there as well. Dixon.
Another one-on-one strip.
They've gone to the Cameron Munster School of Strips.
They're definitely looking for it.
Foxwell. Westcott, six to go here. They've given another opportunity. Wallace on two. Fanon Galoa, I think that is. Wallace again in the middle. He's been strong through that middle. Setting it up just 2 metres out. Westcott goes to the right. Foxwell shapes a kick. Out to Tuengay and on to Taki Taki. What a great bit of play there for diving over for a try in the corner. Taki Taki for the West Panthers.
I think Taki Taki can thank Ballinger there for the one-on-one strip to give them the opportunity.
Watching the strip here. Certainly said he was tackled there. Hallahan wasn't happy with that. He thought he was free. Watching it go white right here. Setting it up Wallace under the sticks.
Seven Foxwell here does a great job at shaping it up. Ten with the run. The shape to kick might have just filled the defence bit. Lovely cutout ball to Wangi there. And then a great pass to Taki Taki again. Couldn't quite see the finish, but did a great job.
Well, the you couldn't see it on the screen, but we could see it live. It was a great show and go there from Foxwell aiming to kick, then a bit of a double pump, which brought Dixon in a little bit. The winger for Normanby came in a little bit, left his wing, which then allowed for that little bit of gap, and certainly seeing it here.
See it again, Foxwell, I think he just fills them, double pumps, kicks, and then shapes to kick.
Just outside his man.
You would have been happy with that one, Brendan, in your day.
Oh, yeah, look, certainly. I'd be happy with any tries, Ben. Actually, any tackles I would have been happy with, but certainly a valuable try just running. We're in the last 10 minutes before halftime. Bit of a coach killer, they always say. And I think even though Normanby would be a bit disappointed with that result, I think West Panthers just missing that kick there. So the score remains at 8-4. West Panthers certainly have been faultless in there's been hardly any errors coming out of their own half. Mistake-free football, and then they've had three turnovers in this half. Yeah. So that's been the turning points in the game so far. And I think that's what Coach Aliana Mara will certainly to his boys when they get in the shed. So.
They just need to hold the ball. Whenever they've had the ball, they've dominated.
So, West, from here, what's your thoughts? What would Coaches Ingridson be calling out saying? What would they be saying now?
Yeah, he was offside, the 11.
Bit of a false start there.
Samuel, that's a real coach killer, that one.
That one is.
Tearing the air out. Well, West will just take confidence knowing that they've only been down here twice and they've scored twice. So they just know they've got to just defend really well, hold the ball, and the opportunities are going to come.
And with certainly, you know, the need to keep the hounds on the back foot, West Panthers here taking a quick kick. Trying to keep going, and Wallace, who's had a strong start since he's come on. Seeing up just inside the 30. Westcott, that's on a Fonongoloa. He's been strong as well. Just keeping in his lane, just going straight through the middle.
Just doing his job.
Britton Snowden. Foxwell hitting Ballinger with a short pass there. Good strong defence on the third. Van Claveren, Foxwell. That's Vivale under the sticks, right in front, two to go. Punching wide, Britton Snowden hitting his man. Opportunity. Oh, he's called that a double movement there. Temptation was certainly there just to reach out, wasn't it?
It's a great tackle from Campbell.
Great
try saver.
Watching the replay here.
Yeah, Campbell just gets his legs and couldn't resist.
We see him just promoting the ball just on that line. A bit of mouth there too.
Yeah.
You know, obviously, Ben, you're used to giving a bit of lip in your time, so you've been marched 10 metres many times, yeah, haven't you?
Learned from the best, mate.
Well, if the Hounds had a terrible start to that set by being offside, they've got out of jail. And they've got the tap here.
Zeb Samuel will be very happy for that tackle with
Campbell. Yes. Allen and Rucky up there. Don't see that enough, you know. Normally they do one pass off from that tap, but the centres are starting to take it, the tap, and they're making 10 metres straight from that first tap. So great work there from Hallinan. That's straight up the middle. The only way he knows. We've got here, looks like
that's Samet, found a bit of room.
Oh, shoulder charge. Just dropped the shoulder on him, watching the replay here.
Sammy found a bit of room in between the ruck and
Wallace.
16. Wallace, he's been strong, but he's on report for that too, Brennan.
Is he? Well, that's I think it might have been the 17 front blower that was on.
You'll be able to give him some tips to the judiciary.
Out. Right in front. Another lost ball. There's ball in the strip to the tackle. Involving the tape, the tackle without the ball by the looks of it. So they're setting up here. So Clifton taking a quick tap onto Perry. Rocking it straight through the middle. Seeing it up 3 metres out. Lost his strides there. Campbell. Six to go, being offside. West Panthers getting a bit too anxious. Mopo injured, slow. Out the back here, Downing Brown with the ball. Beats the first tackle. He runs straight back into his big tackle again there from Ballinger. Forster taking it up, taking a hit up. So Clifton, dummy half, Mopo. On there, that's McNulty. Strong run out wide. Campbell wrapping around the short side. That's the way they're going. And a bit loose on that ball. Up inside the 10 metres. Wes.
He's sent to the bin.
First one gone to the bin. That's the third penalty, or six again in a row. Time off here. Certainly, we're watching it here again. Need for the simple, I think we've got there, Tuatali. Tuatali, the man that's been called out. And
he doesn't want to go, but looks.
He doesn't want to go. He's been given his marching orders again. Does that mean he gets 20 metres, 20 minutes? He's been given it twice there. But no, he's slowly making his way off the field there. But that's three penalties and 3 6-agains. Sorry, three penalties or six against. in a row, so they've and certainly not making his way off too quickly to Itali.
Big opportunity for the Hounds here, 4 minutes before half time.
Yeah. So they're still setting it up.
Big Perry straight up the middle, first one.
He's been strong too. No, setting it straight up to Forster, who's going straight in the middle of the field.
Another penalty. Might have another one go yet.
Another strip there. That time it's Perry straight up the middle. So Wes doing the hard yards here, another intercept.
Another penalty.
He was accidental offside there, I believe, but he couldn't really do too much. Dempsey's got the rebound straight into his hand, but he didn't have to play it, I suppose. But yeah, another penalty here. Oh, they see this penalty counter here, Nudo. So I think that's Samu rocking it up, setting it up. Clifton under the sticks. Campbell drawing pass, and the big fella out wide with the McNulty diving over the corner. The weight of possession there going the Hounds' way. Something had to give. Panthers have been defending tirelessly, but with that weight of possession, show and go from Campbell. Drawing pass over to McNulty over in the corner for an equaling try.
Big fellas love a meat pie, don't they? He'll be happy with that one. Saw a bit of space and just pinned the ears.
Watch Campbell here. In and away. Pump, pump. Callaghan just leaving the line a bit.
Yeah, he just slid past the ball and came up. And
once you go past the ball, you can't do that.
I opened the space for Campbell there, and then the six, Britton Snyder, had to come in, and that created the gap for our try scorer, McNulty.
McNulty going over in the corner. That was excellent work there from Campbell. He's had a very strong half.
Yeah.
His kicking game has been brilliant. He's been controlling both sides of the ruck, and he saw the opportunity there. He noticed a bit of a show, a bit of an in and out step for himself there. We'll see it here. You watch how, when he goes in and out, sees Callaghan leave the line, goes in behind him, draws and pass. Great work there for McNulty backing up.
Sounded up beautifully, didn't he? And McNulty had Callaghan and Tamura out there screaming for a try as well, but got over himself, didn't need him.
With the possibility of going into half time here with a 2-point lead, so.
A Mopo coming in.
Just going under the bar, so scores are level at 8-all. Just over a minute left in the first half there. Well, I'm not sure how coaches, both Ingebrigtsens, will be about that, but there was a number of penalties, a number of six agains that time for West, and a man in the bin. They'll be looking for half time, I think. So, strong kickoff here, and a knock on. West picking it up, but they're going to play the original knock on. First here, well, is there another sting in the tail? The last 40-odd seconds left in the half.
Coach Mara would be fuming with that one, straight after.
Well,
points.
He would have been walking to the sheds and seeing that. Now he's stopped. They've got a pack here. Last, still got just over 20 seconds to go. So lucky there that they didn't pick the ball up and scoot over. He was forced into touch. So they've got time for one, possibly two plays here. West Panthers, what have they got going here, think you?
Yeah, I think a similar trick shot off the scrum again. They got them their first try will be the play.
Ben Clavering to the right. No. Gone. Well, it's Foxwell setting it up. We'll get time for two last plays, I'd say. Wallace from dummy half diving over. Well, that's exactly what the Hounds didn't want to have. They were thinking halftime. They were thinking oranges, but going to sleep at that dummy half marker position. That's certainly, look at them hanging their heads there. That was exactly what they didn't want. Wallace has had a dynamic start since he came on. Dummy.
Just the one settler off the scrum here. Wallace, he's got the chocolates there. He's been really strong this half. Yeah, you're right. I think you just caught the hound sleeping. Two there at marker, one on the ground. And, geez, Coach Mara will be fuming after that drop. They only had to probably get tackled three or four times, and now they're behind.
Well, the
could be costly.
The half-time talk has certainly changed, hasn't it? I mean, it would have been Mara would have been going in there praising his troops for the amount of tackling and great attack of eyes up football that they've been playing this half. They would have been going in 8-all with a man in the bin still for the Panthers, but instead, knock on from the kickoff, West setting up from the scrum, one player to the left, diving over, and the conversion is successful, which means they're going to go into half time now. West Panthers leading the Hounds 14-8. We'll take a short break here, listeners, and we'll be back soon with the second half for our Chaos Gear Round 14 clash for BRL Premiership A grade. Back here to the second half of the round 14 clash between West Panthers and the Normanby Hounds. West Panthers going into second half with a narrow lead, 14-8. Benny Newton, what did you think of that first half?
Yeah, mate, it was tightly contested. I think the Hounds would be a bit disappointed to concede that last one, but good game of footy so far. It's been tight, hasn't it?
Who stood out for you?
I think for the Hounds, Campbell's been excellent, just controlling in the middle of the field. His kicking game's been great, and the forwards, Forster and McNulty, taking a lot of tough runs and making a lot of metres. For West, the back three, Van Claveren, have been excellent, making a lot of metres, helping out the forwards there in the middle. I think Wallace, the try scorer on half-time, he's been excellent in and around the ruck. He's looked really busy. He's been my pick.
What about, so if you're in the position now of the coaches, what would you be thinking now going into the second half?
I think if I'm the Hounds, I want to hold the ball. They keep throwing away those opportunities. The score could have been anything for them. And on the try line, I think they need to get off it. A bit of line speed. And for West, they just need to fix up their discipline. They've got a man in the bin right now, which is a great example of that. And they keep letting the Hounds back into the game.
All right, thank you. And with about 8 minutes left in the bin there for Tuatali, West will want to hold on to this ball as much as possible. So a good strong run there from Tuangati. That was Wakalevu. Good strong Fonolongoa. Big bumper bars up as he left, started that ruck there. Good strong running here. So I think it's Dempsey running through the middle. Wallace again. They're making some metres here. Straight through the middle ruck. Dummy half. Looking for that quick play. That was Westcott. Last play here. Nice short kick there from Foxwell. Up.
Tackled in the air.
Tackled in the air, but was he? He didn't really have a go
tried
at him.
Tried to pull out, didn't he? We'll see it on the replay.
Was there a chance of playing an advantage here? Because even though they did make contact, they didn't actually hurt him in the air or did tackle him in the air. And he landed the ground safely. We'll see it here. And he actually took off, so perhaps playing advantage.
I think the Panthers come out with some serious intent there. They'll be really disappointed with that.
Yeah.
Piggyback out.
So they're starting their set from halfway. Just Clifton using... Oh, good solid hit there. Oh, he's somewhat illegal though. So what's that? That's Vivali.
He made that big barnstorming run before. He's come out with some real intent here. He's very physical.
Campbell just marshalling the troops again, just selling them down. Finding touch on the 30-metre line.
Certainly haven't sorted out that discipline.
No, they haven't yet. And can ill afford to do that with one man in the bin. So I think that's Perry. Forster. Another good hit there. Working hard. I think that's Dempsey in the middle there. Cut out pass. So there's Hallinan, who's dropped the ball and pulled up a bit injured there. Hamstring.
Gone.
Gone, you reckon? Can't quite see it down there, but he's certainly not in a good way. He's walking it off, but...
Might be just giving himself an excuse.
Well, letting the Panthers off there, Ben, after that early penalty. With one man still in the bin, they needed that opportunity there now to reset.
It's four or five times now they've dropped it right on the line there, the Hounds, so they've got to be disappointed with that.
Setting up here, so we've got Wakalevu. He's struggling here, Hallinan. Sitting out just on the right wing. Don't know if it's cramp or if it's hamstring, but Wakalevu taking it off the scrum. Good, strong, hard running from the winger. Making it out to the 20. And just what the Panthers needed. Quick tap. May have caught them offside there, but no, the ref said it was fine. So got another 10 metres there. Straight up the middle with Fonongoloa. Well, Callahan knocking his own blokes out of the middle. Geez, they've come out with intent now. Britton Snowden out to Foxwell. Is it Ballinger? Great offload there. But it's gone to the ground. Wackaloo. Oh!
We're right in line there.
We're right in line with that. We'll see a great replay of that. Even though his weight was going backwards as he offloaded, that's what Wes is saying, and it still went backwards.
I think he might have been a bit unlucky here.
So Wackaloo diving on the ball there. Well, the motion was still going backwards, wasn't it? So
no challenge at this level.
No, just the abuse from the sideline. Yeah. So that's no doubt going to happen with the home ground advantage. But again, like you said at halftime there, Benny Newton, you cannot afford to have mistakes when you've got one man down. So we see them setting up again here. Scrum right in the middle. Campbell feeding the scrum.
Looks like the message from the Ingbritton brothers was pretty clear. Run as hard as you can.
Straight through the middle. Get the meters.
They've come out to some serious intent.
Bit of silly buggers in the scrum there, Benny. Just resetting there, Campbell.
Not what they used to be, the scrums, are they?
Clifton. Amopo handing off to Dixon there. Make his way back right where the scrum was. Trying for the one-on-one strip again. Dixon's aware of that. Six to go. Too many people. Great, strong run there from Perry. I think that's Samu making his way straight through the middle. Plenty of meters there. Good defense there from Foxwell. Doing his part in the middle there. Campbell. McNulty. Man falling off him, but he gets back. Makes a take. Did he get up and play? He did. He's called play on there. Good Downing Brown making his way. Elusive and getting through the line just short. Head up there and they're making their way. They're like putting him out. No, he's held there. Called held. Downing Brown. Very elusive. Dummy. Trying to dive over just short. Clifton in there, dummy half. Cutting out, that's Tamua. Oh, a kick here from Perry. Out wide. And that's probably why the props don't kick here,
he's
Ben.
He's lost his kicking license.
Yep.
If he ever had it.
Seven tackle. Tucky Tucky taking that ball up.
It's another disappointing end of the set for the Hounds. Another opportunity.
Oh, and that's definitely what they needed. Hey? Now Perry's compacted that. He's done. He got the ball in a position where he probably shouldn't have been. Did a poor kick in the end, and now he's given away the penalty. So he gave away the seven set, and now he's given away a penalty on the 40 metres. So West Panthers get a chance to breathe with their man down. Still, no, they're back to full strength now. So. Both teams on 13. Just as Tuatali has rejoined. So Wallace rocking up the middle again. The legs pumping, post contact meters, making it all the way through to the 30. Foxwell out. So Callahan taking the tackle, going down the blind side. Tuatali has had a good break. What's he doing here? In and out, taking it to the middle, resetting for his team.
Six to go.
Six to go there. This is Fonagaloa making it tough. Very close. Taking men with him all the way. Long pass out there to Brent Snowden. Who takes back inside, steps off his right. Right again, straightens up, just short of the line. Wallace again, is he going over like he did in the first half? He's trying, he's wrestling. They're having a look there. Just short. Just short again. Following goal, Troy's crash over, last tackle. Just short again, great defense here from Normanby Hounds. Oh, kicking for the winger here, there's men out wide. Oh, great work there from Dixon who got up high.
Taken out in the air.
Taken out in the air. And well, he's penalised for dragging back into the in-goal area there. So not so much in the air. Watching the replay here. Britton Snowden Yeah.
I think it might have been in the air.
Well, he's signalling there. He's pulling him back in. The referee there saying he's pulling him back in. Didn't quite see how that happened, but, well, what a relieving penalty.
Another penalty from the Panthers. Very ill-disciplined.
We see a replacement coming on for the Panthers who need that interjection. We see Velicott joining the line. Comes out for the first hit as well.
There he is, that's our man, Velicott.
And a one-on-one strip.
He's giving away a penalty.
Fanongaloa there. Call for Velicott to... What's going on here? There's a...
Going to be a warning, too many penalties again.
Well, he's calling the captain out here. Not happy with the amount of penalties. Asking them all to please settle down because there was a bit of a chat around that. They said one person, there was only one in the tackle, but not according to the referee. He's asking them to settle down here. It's got potential to be heat up this game here, Ben.
Bit of fire in it. That's what the punters want to see. Reckon we'll see a gaggle of Burton. Likes to doubt.
Anything is possible when there's passion in rugby league. Two balls on. Just a settling ruck there. That's McNulty, the try scorer in the first half. On to Zafeo back on now. He was very strong in that first half as well. Clifton out to Perry. Setting it up right on the 20, just inside their own 20. That's Fayo handing off there. Panthers also looking for the one-on-one strip again there. Through the middle again, Fayo. Spivali underneath there. Last tackle. A great, oh! What's happened here? Six to go, again is the call. So Grubber kick through. People going for it left, right and centre, but Normie Hounds come up with again. Six to go. Oh, what a great hit! Shot. Is that Fanongaloa?
Yeah, it was. Great shot.
What a great shot by Perry. It's rattled him as well. Campbell got the ball. Show and go. And he's been hit in the tackle. Great hit there from Callahan. Going to the right. Fullback Downing Brown. Cut out ball. What a great cut out ball. That's Wakalevi just leaving his wing there, but Tamua on the paint there, right on the wing. Can't quite see it on our replay, but on the paint, diving over in the corner, untouched. What a great
try scoring corner, isn't it?
Well, Campbell setting it up, taking the hit here. Downing Brown taking it first off the ruck. Double cutout, hits his winger on the fly. Tamua. What a great try there, and much needed try there for the Normanby Hounds.
It's a great ball from Downey Brown. He was dangerous in the first 20 minutes of the game, and he's come back alive. Great feet again, and a great ball. Clifton actually pushed him out of dummy half, which turned out to be good for a good reason.
But this game is nowhere near over here, Ben Newton. He's with a score at 14-12, kick to come on the sideline, right in front of some of the West supporters. I don't think he'll be getting too much encouragement down there, Newt.
That's the moment you dream of as a goal kicker, isn't it?
Seeing here on the replay again, what a great cutout ball. Reminds me of a Queensland fullback there with headgear and a sleight of frame and a cutout ball. So,
geez, he was good Wednesday night, wasn't he?
He was brilliant.
Campbell copying it down there.
Yeah, he's copying it. Just spraying it to the left there, Campbell. So the score remains the same. West Panthers 14, Normanby Hounds 12.
You mentioned it earlier, the goal kicking. Very important. Might prove the difference here.
Well, it was... You know, surprisingly, you know, that West had the numbers there. They had, and I know the Hounds that have been attacking the left side defence of the Panthers because Tuatali was off for the Sydney for all, but he was on then, so they numbered off well enough. Yeah. Their winger just left.
Wakalevu just left his post.
All right, well, there needs to be something special happen here. They're rucking it out. I think we're fine. So Feo. That's McNulty. Try scoring the first half. That one's Perry. Rucking it up the middle. Panthers turning him on his back there. Oh, short ball there from Homopo.
Samuel pokes his nose through. All down.
Gave himself up there. Would have been a shepherd. Forster. Nope. Looking for the kick here from Campbell. Great pressure there. Ben Claverin hasn't had much chance in this second half. Taking on the attack.
Good set from the Panthers there defensively. They've already on the 30. They're coming out of their own half.
Wakalevu needs to make up for that miss there. Just leaving his line alone on that try to in. He's getting in there doing some hard work. Here's Tuatali, the sin man that went to the sin bin early. He's been hard to put down. He's then breaks through that tackle. Makes it into the halfway. Callahan. Sorry, that's Ballinger. Going to the right. That's Lockie Velikot. Through the first tackle. Making his way into the 30. Leaving men on the ground. Oh, and that's Dempsey with a short kick in the in-goal area. But Downing Brown cleaning it up there. They're holding him up and dragging him back. This will be the first restart for the game. First time they've been able to do that. Most have been going to the dead ball line or catching it on the full. So a good set there from Wes.
Yeah, great kick out of dummy half and a lovely chase. And the lightweight Downing Brown. Not strong enough for the three defenders there. Just West with the ascendancy.
Just what the Panthers needed there, just to get back on top. So now they've got a repeat set. Brad Campbell looking for that long kick. Always not, hasn't got all of it. Caught there by Brent Snowden, handing off to Fonagaloa. Just leaves, and he's still going. Hands off, what great.
Ooh. It's getting physical this game, Brendan.
Wakalevu certainly came in just when they needed. Velikot through the middle. Setting up on the third tackle. Numbers left. Foxwell. It's out to Tuatali. He's been hard to put down. Standing in his tackles. On the fourth. Marshalling their troops out wide on the right. Brent Snowden. Setting it up here. Fonagaloa. Right in the middle. Still walking. Can't put him down. On the fourth. Brent Snowden setting up his troops out wide. Ballinger taken down there on the last tackle. Dempsey rushing the dummy half. Going to the right. Short kick. In the in-goal area. Dixon putting it out. Repeat sets is the name of the game at the moment for the West Panthers.
Great kicking game from Dempsey so far in the second half.
He's found himself in there at dummy half a couple of times, so good pressure there. So Normie Hounds have to reset here. This will be at the end of this, so they'll be looking at this third set, 18 tackles. Can they hold out? I think for their game's sake, they need to hold out. Brent Snowden got the ball, and off the back fence now, we've got Boyton. Lumping up and just always hard to tackle, long strides. Brent Snowden, Velikot. Post-contact meters marching through. Takes three to put him down. Dempsey, dummy half. Callahan, Tuatali, left-handed pass. Wakalevu off to Tuatali again. Back inside, looking for a man running. Boyton through the middle. Can they hold him out? They're holding up four men in the tackle, driving him back. Still hasn't been put to the ground, plays it. Dempsey to the right. Brent Snowden, hard to tackle as well. Can he offload there? West Panthers punishing this defensive line. The big fella through the middle. Fanongaloa, he's been damaging all day off the back fence. Punches through the middle. A weight of possession, certainly hard to hold back. And he scores underneath the sticks. A very much needed try for the Panthers, but it was very hard to hold them out for a third set of six there as we watched the replay.
Yeah, big 17, he comes off the back fence. This is the play before Brent Snowden.
You can see that
Fanongaloa just isolates the defender there. He's hard to stop one-on-one, a metre out from the line, I think. Couple of big fellas getting some tries. Good to see.
Can we also pay a bit of homage there to Lockie Velicott, the 15? You'll see that he ran the dummy play. He ran through and sucked in three defenders, which allowed the gap to be open underneath the stick. So great work there from all the West forwards, because they planned that. And you'll see next time the replay comes up that Velicott ran in at the angle, back into the ruck and into the markers, and he took out three defenders, or took the eye of three defenders. They didn't see the pass out the back going to the try scorers of Fanongaloa, who has been strong all game so far. Watching it here. What's the 15, Velicott? We're just going out to the right. That was Dempsey on to Brenton Snowden, and takes the tackle. Look at 17, he's going there. Velicott running straight, the 15. Watch him go, sucks in four defenders, leaves the gap there. Fanongaloa, I think, owes Velicott a beer for that one.
Velicott certainly looks like he's put on a few kegs and some muscle since his cricketing days out in Ipswich, Chris.
Yeah, but certainly, but he's living the dream at the moment here in the Premiership leading West Panthers. So
he's been good since he's come on, he's been busy.
He has indeed. Bit of a time delay here, that there was an injury. I think we'll find McNulty who's done a weight of tackling in this half already, has come off a bit injured there. We're right to take the kick now, but McNulty will leave the field. So important kick here at the moment. Score 18-12, kick to come. Brenton Snowden should just put this one over to take an 8-point lead, which he does. West Panthers in the chaos gear. Round 14 clash. West Panthers 20, Normanby Hounds 12. Still got a quarter of the match to go now. What can the Hounds do from here, Ben?
They just need to aim up here. Big set in defence here. Keep them down here and build that pressure again. And when they get down there, they just got to hold the ball. They keep getting down there. They just haven't got over the line.
Making sure they're onside here for the kickoff. Ben Claverin to Boyton. Look at that, straight through the middle. Hard running. Making it up to the 30. Every prop stream to make it to 30 from the kickoff. I think that was Vivali. No, sorry, that was Dempsey. To Atali. Taking it to the middle. Be very elusive. Obviously, Westcott back on now. Boyden again for his second run in the set. Chopped down there. Great tackle there from Campbell. Going to the left. Brent Snowden. Beating tackles. Standing in the tackle. They still can't put him down. Going to the left. Ben Claverin. Kicking back to the middle. Downey Brown underneath it, takes it well, and he's through, he's made gap. Very loose, he's had a strong game. Dempsey make it, putting him down there on the 30. Dixon rucking it out. This is the opportunity, I think, Ben, that they've got to start spreading at this point, because while West Panthers are getting their defensive line reset, they need to do something.
Yeah, they're very bunched, they're looking tired, but Downey Brown, he's the man, I think. He looks very elusive.
Got to get himself more involved. Onto a new runner here. They're going a bit higher than they should have. He's found his way to the ground, made to the 40. A it's Clifton out from dummy half. Last tackle here. Campbell getting it high. Ben Claverton underneath it. A metre out taking it. Good contact there from Hopo.
Good set there from the Hounds end and footy here.
The tacky tacky. Oh, good. Oh, high shot there. The play on. No. Tuanagi got caught there a little bit high. Just checking up on him. I think that's Finch who caught him high there. I think you'll find Finch has already had a. He's calling him out here. Put him on report. Got a couple of high ones. Just through the chops as they went through there, but well, penalties they can't afford to give away here. Just watching it on the replay.
Yeah, just stuck an arm out.
Yeah, don't know if it, Finch got him the second time, but I think that may have been Faye. West Panthers looking dangerous here, setting up on the 30 metre line after the first tackle. It's Ballinger looking for offload. Just couldn't get it away there. Foxwell arrived a little bit too late. Westcott cutting it out. Brent Snowden, good hit there. Callahan. Campbell calling his troops to help him out. Velicott just knows his lane. Westcott cut out Van Cleveren. Short kick through. Unfortunately, no chases there. Ball going dead. Seven tackle. Normie need to get out of here. They don't know if there's much energy left for them, though.
Yeah. West are just, they're starting to flex their muscles here a bit, aren't they?
Yeah, Campbell calling on his troops to do something. They just don't have much energy left. Good offload there off to Downing Brown. Playing on the third, he gets a penalty. Relieving penalty there. Well, this is what the, with only 16 minutes left in the game, Hounds need to do something here. And is he going to make, he's not going to find touch. Oh, wow, that is bad.
Another mistake.
Goes back infield. Finds Brent Snowden. Off to Boyton. Making his way to the middle where he knows best. Takes four men with him. Westcott, Dempsey, Brent Snowden looking for that offload, just couldn't get it. Brent Snowden, Velicott, offloaded to Atali. Oh, he's evaded, he's been two. Just couldn't get, be the last one. Numbers right. Brent Snowden, cut out. Oh, knocked down. Dixon going for the intercept there. Knocking the ball down. Playing a knock on there from the West Panthers, seeing the replay here. Cut out ball. No, they're just saying that.
I think Dixon knocked it in to Tuwangi there, and Tuwangi's knocked it back on. So it must have went back off Dixon.
So that's what they're ruling. Dixon perhaps knocking it back.
It's a try saver from Dixon.
Tuanagi, he must have knocked on, so it keeps the Hounds in it. It was a try saver, probably a match saver then, you.
Yeah, Tucky Tucky was in, untouched. He had it gone in. Downing Brownie's been good.
Good defence there from Brent Snowden. Through the middle there, Finch. Three men in the tackle, three men are taking down. He still kept working. Wakalevu in there as well. He'll be looking to get a try as well before the match is out. A good offload there, but intercepted. Intercepted by the defence. That was Velicott coming back onside. Found the ball in his hands. So Normie just can't get down the other end of the field. We're still applying that pressure. Cutting out wide. So that's cut out ball there. Tuanagi, is that still? Still going well, bringing it back in field. 20 in, 15 out, going to the right. Good cutout pass. Seemed a lot simpler than what you thought. Yeah. Ballinger just an in and out ball there from Foxwell. Ballinger finding himself in a bit of gap, dummy to his winger, and just made his way over to. Seemed like a very soft try, this one.
Yeah, they just had the numbers there. And the try scorer, Ballinger, just too big, too strong for Dixon. I think it was the run before that sort of set that one up and had the hounds short on the right, on their left, and West made the most of it.
I mean, they'll be coming back to the fact they got a penalty on halfway and failed to put the ball in the touch. That's going to be, we say it all the time, coach killers, but that's where the difference has been in this game. These little, they're not even 1%ers, they're like 50%ers. You know, they're big turning points in the game. If they're going to get back in the game here, Normanby, they need to stop making those simple errors. Just keep doing the basics, which now I think we're finding the West Panthers are doing it, and they're doing it really well. They're just holding the ball then for that set of six, and they just found themselves a tiring defence in front of them. And I mean, about 15 minutes ago, when West had three sets of six, that took a lot out of the defence for Normanby. So they're just now playing percentage play and reaping the benefits for it. Kick to come here from Britton Snowden. Simon hasn't had all the easiest kicks today, so he's done really well. Hasn't converted one of these from the sideline yet, but he's looking to do this one. This one needs this kick. Good contact, but just shaves the right hand upright. Score remains 24-12. So time off here for an injury for the West Panthers. I know he's just a bit of a cramp, so he's getting treatment back on the 40 metre line over there. So, but he's right to go. So two tries. So that was a good miss for Normanby, really.
Keeps them in it, doesn't it? It
does keep them in it. So this BRLA grade, proudly sponsored by Chaos for driving camping. Off the back, oh no, he's not. Dempsey was looking for that ball off the back fence. Buckley takes the ball comfortably. He's got it now though, Dempsey, through the middle. He's had a strong game. Another 10 metre carry. The Stakitaki. Sorry, that was Tuafeo. An early kick here from Foxwell. Punching in the back corner and a good strong chase here. The Stakitaki now getting Dixon right on the line. Oh, he's
pushed him back again.
Yeah, a second tackle, perhaps. I thought there was a bit of momentum there, but we're watching it here. Good early kick here. Foxwell letting his wingers know. Good early kick. He was onside. Great kick into the corner. The weight was pretty good.
I think the Panthers might be a bit unlucky there, Brendan.
Well, the question being, what could he do? Let's just say, I think the Panthers have given away a lot more penalties than what they wanted to, I'd say. They've been on the wrong end of the penalty count today. We see Normanby certainly trying to make their way out. He's worked hard, Faye. And he's still going. He's holding Boyton in there. Gee, he's worked hard, the big fella. Inside ball. That's Finch. Strong contact. Campbell again. Who's going with him? He's underneath the tackles. He's in the backfield, coming out to the fullback. Kicks through. That's Tamua getting the ball.
Ah, oh, great try.
A great bounce, an A-grade bounce there for Tamua, who made his way supporting on the outside. Campbell, we'll see a great replay of this. Campbell getting his way under tackles, through tackles, making his way in the backfield, looking left, looking right. Look at this, Finch leaving players in his wake there. Campbell, one off the ruck, doing it all himself. Dummies, inside, underneath.
Just caught Boyton asleep Boyton there.
What does he do here? He kicks off his wrong foot.
That's great footy, Brandon, from Campbell. Real eyes up footy.
What a great bounce there for Tamura as well.
And Sammy, the big fella, he was right there too.
The Normanby Hounds are not out of this game yet. They just refuse to give up, Ben.
Big kick this.
I think they're riding on the coattails at the moment of Campbell. They need people around him to back him up. He shouldn't be taking it one out off the ruck in his own half. He should be the one dishing off to the other players, but Campbell needs people to go with him. And the conversion there. Conversion there. 24-18, West Panthers.
I'd like to see Danny Brown just keep sniffing around the ruck there. They went inside a few times and they made some metres there. Pretty easy metres, the Hounds.
They need energy now.
That should give it to them.
So Downing Brown, he's the man to back up your Campbell. Get the outside backs, Hallinan and O'Donoghue, Tamura and Dixon. Get all them in the back. They need some metres. Very high kickoff there from Van Claveren. Great take. Finch. Good first contact there from Vellacott. Downing Brown, dash from dummy half. Tied defence.
That try's giving him some energy.
There's plenty of talk. Oh, making him go back a bit, is he? Overstep the mark. They get a lot of extra metres like that, don't they?
It's a momentum killer, that.
They had it too. Finch taking his second ruck in this six. Still got time. Amopo dishing off. Amopo, dummies. Ooh. Nearly gets through. Just a jersey sling there from Vellacott. Finch again. Third. A great tackle. Oh, no. Lifted in the tackle. I tell you what, I'd like to see the penalty count. We're watching it here. Finch in his third ruck in that set. Lifted and driven. I think that was Dempsey that got him.
Just over the horizontal.
And mounting off again. Off.
They're losing at the Panthers.
So that's another penalty.
They're frustrated.
Brad Campbell takes a tap. Off to Forster, the international. They can't put him down. Vellacott gets hold of him. Finch. Good meters. Straight through the middle. Lifted again and finished off there. Six to go. Ball. Dempsey getting untidy there. Amopo taking it. He's a meter out. They've got a six again here. What are they going to do with it? Campbell. Inside, out. Uses the fullback. Oh, intercept!
Oh,
no. Wakalevu leaves his wing. And rightfully so, because he took the intercept with two more men outside him. Ben Claveren. Well, that was a timely intercept.
Had to catch it or it was a try. The men were on the outside.
He hasn't scored a try this half, but he certainly saved one there and possibly the match. And now he's found himself through the middle. And great offload there. Tucky Tucky following up his wing partner there. Great work. Oh, now Tuanagi. He's found his way through the middle. The outside backs have got him out of danger here, Ben Newton.
I've turned attack into defence into attack.
Cut out ball.
Cool.
Oh. And they had the numbers too.
It was the right option.
It was. Just floated forward there. Eyes mouthed off.
They might have another one in the bin.
They might have another one here for the last 10 minutes the way they're going. Mouthing off. So it wasn't just a forward pass. It's compounded now. They're going to give them another 20 metres. Oh, just. Well, let's say another 15 metres. But setting up with 5 minutes to go, this game's not over yet. That's Forster rucking it up there. It's just over the halfway line. New player, I think that's Hunter, who's coming here, fresh legs. Finch. Straight out there. So that's that's Fayai again.
Finch has been busy.
Has been busy since he's coming. Six to go again. Campbell. Finch. Making meters. Down there on the 12 out. And that's only the first tackle on this set. Samu from dummy half. Pushing. Driven back there. 2 meters out. Clifton at dummy half here now. Campbell. Backline move. Oh! Has that been touched there? Driven back. Dixon got the ball right back on the 42-metre line. So,
no, 6 to go, call either.
No, I thought there must have been a touch there, but, well, that's... Look at the pressure. The lead. Oh, no! That's... I think that was O'Donoghue there. Well, is that the end, Ben Ute?
It's another chance going begging from the Hounds.
Great, good timely turnover there for the West Panthers. But what are they doing here? Dempsey, got to get him out. He's been tough all game. Look, he's hard to put down. Just looks to drive in that tackle. Makes it into the second, in the other half. Straight through the middle here. Now we've got Tufoe. Good meters. Good meters. Is it? Are they setting up perhaps for an attacking kick, a field goal? Knocked it backwards there. But they've got time there. Foxwell. Straight to the captain, Brent Snowden. Falling over there. Westcott. Van Claveren. Cutting out to Boyden. Off to Tuatali. Kick through. Trying to pick it up. What's happened here? Oh, it's pretty mess. Ugly.
Knock on Panthers.
Knock on Panthers. With 2.5 minutes to go. What's the trick play here, Ben Newton?
Got to go coast to coast here, the Hounds. I think Campbell's the man, and geez, Finch is looking busy.
Van Claveren taking control there. Boyden taking that ball off to Tuatali, who... put that kick and don't know if they really needed that then.
Not
I mean,
sure.
Had a chance to sell it back and put one in the in-goal area or even go for the field goal to
not
ice
the smart
it.
Play, I don't think.
But anyway, it's done now. And 2 minutes, so probably definitely one set, maybe
probably
another.
Probably their last set, the Hounds.
The way things are going, they might get a six again anyway. Or a penalty. No, that one's around the chest. So Dixon taking the first tackle there. They need to do something here. They need some energy. Campbell marshalling his troops out wide. He's talking to them. Needs another settler. Through the middle, and this is Faye. Knocking people over. He's got an offload there. That's on the third. 1 minute 20 left. Campbell looking in, out. Caught with the ball. Boyden coming over, finishing him off. Danny Brown, what's he got? Has he got a run in him?
Here
he's coming down the blind.
Special. Beats two. Oh, just ankle tap.
Been elusive. Two. Last tackle. Last chance here. Campbell. Cut out
running
ball.
It.
Looking for the ball. Needs a cut out of something. Tamua there. Off by his last tackle. Still the last tackle. The big fella's through the middle.
Oh, he's dropped it.
Oh, unlucky there. Forsu's had a great game. Great game there, and the boys are all out on their feet with 40 seconds to go. There's a turnover there, and West Panthers taking the ball.
Should be enough to get the chocolates, I think, Brendan.
Well,
30
they're
going to
be wary here of the men down left, right, and centre here for Normanby, but they're still calling to play the ball. They've called time off now. 20-odd seconds to go. Van Claveren taking a settler. Nice and simple. They're looking for the one-on-one strip. They're looking for something special here. Who's got something from the Normanby? Waka Lever here just taking a precious time. This is the last chance. And there's it. The Hooter brings the game to conclusion here, Benny Newton. Valiant effort from the Hounds. But West Panthers, who held on despite a heavy penalty count and six against them, they held on for a great victory here, 24-18.
Great game of footy, Brendan. The Hounds really gave them a run for their money there, but the Panthers just showing why they're on top of the ladder, I think. Too strong.
Your eyes, who would have been the best player in your eyes? I think the standout in the Normanby Hounds would have been... Brad Campbell, the halfback, who did everything. Was tireless in attack and defence, actually. He'll need to a lozenge in his throat tonight.
Yeah, set up that try to get him back in the game, too.
And for Panthers?
I think off the bench, actually, Wallace was excellent. And then at the end there, the two props really got the meters, had some serious intent. So I think I'm going to go Tuafoe as my pick in the second half there.
Excellent. And Downing Brown had a great game also for the Hounds. That brings us to conclusion there for round 14 Chaos BRL Premiership, the match between West Panthers and Normanby Hounds. Thank you for listening in, guys. Hope you had a great Saturday afternoon and a lovely weekend. All the best.
Grandma, or one other.